Yeah, I just want to let you know, on our hike out, one of our troop members fell down a hole, and sounds like a severe...
Go ahead, this is Eugene.
Control fails, it's constant breathing, brake. The patient has a possible fracture angle, a lot of pain. Right now, the level of severity is priority. We're working on getting back towards the truck to possibly work better.
You were really broke up. I got the... or I think I have that you're off the fire and you have some priorities in the morning or snags.
You do this, that's
Coffin. Go ahead, Coffin.
Have a possible fractured ankle on their way down the trail. They're working on going down to the trailhead, getting a backboard, and 218, continue after that.
Continue with my 9-line assessment if you're ready to copy. All right, very yellow priority, 6 o'clock. Special equipment needed. I'd like to see the availability of the police aircraft or home aircraft. Great. Currently, we have 2 EMTs on scene with simple equipment. Do not have a live box for OCS. Great.
Last part was patient needs to be exported. Is that what you said?
Very last bit was the agency employee.
She is an agency employee. And are you thinking a hoist aircraft tonight?
Coffin Mountain.
218 Coffin Mountain, are you thinking a hoist aircraft tonight? I couldn't copy.
Copy, stand by. Copy, Mountain 20. Medics would also request a ground ambulance for the monitor, but for the
supervisor. Copy, 218, Copy Mountain, your message is passed, and we'll wait to hear back from them.
Copy, Mountain 218.
218,
Coffin
Mountain, go ahead.
As a contingency, I'd also like to request the 20-person hand crew at Detroit to start heading towards the 1142 road, please.
Copy, you see
this back,
Coffin Mountain.
I copy, they're looking to have a 20-person hand crew headed towards the 1142 road.
Start heading that way as a contingency plan.
I copy contingency plan to have a 20-person crew to help with the extraction.
Okay, dispatch is working on getting you a hoist ship. It is the regional. It could take a couple hours. They do have the crew headed out from Detroit now to the 1142 road. So just in time, we'll need to get the rest of the information off the nightline from you.
12 down here at the trailhead. I got Porter Mount Hood IA. I head back into you. Grand Ron is going to gear up and start clearing trail towards you. Briggs. Additionally, I have the ambulance on scene with me as well as Control 4-2 and inquiring as to whether you still like their medical personnel to hike into your location.
Yes, the EMT says the gentleman, yes, please, yes.
Okay, all right, copy. We'll, I copy, we'll get them lined out. We'll be headed to you shortly.
Yes, for your information, Coast Guard Rescue 6042 is launching, expected over scene in approximately 1.5 hours. Radio will be air-to-ground primary.
The patient has good motor sensation, minor swelling in the injured foot, no visible injuries. Great. Medics have administered 150 micrograms of fentanyl, and they have also administered an IV at this time. Great. The vitals are good, and they're holding at steady and good. And the pain is moderating at this time. So medically, we're looking pretty good right now, pretty stable. How do you come? The incident appears to be holding at 2 acres, although we did have a fair amount of spotting with the rotor wash from the Coast Guard ship break. Plans for the night are going to just be to monitor and hold and spread out along the line and just continue to monitor what we got for tonight. Break. And continuing dispatch, if we could inform Lynn County as well as Fire Chief 201 that Medic 24 will remain on scene and overnight with us, and they are supported and taken care of for the evening. Break. And lastly, I have the remainder of the Grand Ron crew is inbound to the fire, as well as Patrol 4-2. And when they arrive, we'll transfer command of the fire to a qualified IC, and I'll remain as the qualified medical IC for the medical incident.